While deriving the expression of efficiency of the power screw, we have seen the limitation that it does not take into account the other friction losses. What is that other friction loss? That loss of friction is nothing but the friction between the collar and the cup, as shown in the diagram. The torque required to overcome this friction is not considered while deriving the expression. Now let us see what will be the torque required to overcome the friction between this collar and the cup. According to uniform pressure theory, it is given as torque is equal to mu c multiplied by w d0 cube minus di cube divided by 3 d0 square minus di square. Here mu c is the friction between the collar and the cup, as shown in the diagram. D0 is the outer diameter of the collar and di is the inner diameter of the collar. According to uniform wear theory, it is mu c w d0 plus di divided by 4, or we can also write it as mu c multiplied by w multiplied by rm, that is mean radius. Now the point comes, which equation is to be used when? Uniform pressure theory is to be used when the surface of the collar is new, whereas uniform wear theory to be used after initial wear of the collar surface. Hence, logically, we use uniform wear theory for our calculation purpose. As we have now seen about the torque required to overcome friction between the collar and the cup, now let us go towards the overall efficiency of the power screw, which we have not considered earlier. So again, the same relations, efficiency is output upon input, and same work output and same work input we can write. Converting the input in terms of torque, I will get input is equal to torque multiplied by 2 pi. And substituting this value of input, we will get efficiency is equal to W multiplied by L divided by T into 2 pi. The point worth noting in this expression is the value T, that is the value of torque. This torque is the total torque, that is the torque required to overcome the friction between the screw, and the torque required to overcome the friction between cup and the collar. So I can write T is equal to TS plus TC. Till now we have derived all the relations such as efficiency, the torque required to lift the screw, torque required to lower the screw, etc. for the square threaded screws. Now let us look at the expressions if the screws are of trapezoidal or ACME type. While deriving the relation, we had the expression P is equal to W tan phi plus tan alpha divided by 1 minus tan phi into tan alpha. For a trapezoidal or ACME thread, we just need to put the value of tan phi as mu sec theta. Substituting the value of tan phi as mu sec theta, I will get the torque required to lift the screw for a trapezoidal ACME thread is T is equal to W dm mu sec theta plus tan alpha divided by 2 multiplied by 1 minus mu sec theta into tan alpha. Similarly, torque required to lower the screw will be exactly same, just there will be difference of signs, that is plus will become minus. On the same lines, we can also derive the efficiency of a trapezoidal thread as efficiency is equal to tan alpha 1 minus mu sec theta tan alpha divided by mu sec theta plus tan alpha. Here the theta is the thread angle. For trapezoidal threads, we will take theta as 15 degrees or 2 theta as 30, and if it is an ACME thread, we will be using theta as 14.5 degrees or 2 theta as 29 degrees. Previously, we have seen the expressions for efficiency of a square threaded screw. Now let us look about what will be the maximum efficiency of a square threaded power screws. So maximum efficiency for a square threaded power screw is given by the expression 1 minus sin phi divided by 1 plus sin phi. The point worth noting in this expression is the efficiency of the square threaded screw will be maximum when alpha is 45 minus 5 by 2, and this was taken care while deriving the above expression. With this, we have completed about the theoretical aspects of the power screw. From the next class, we will start with the problems. Thank you.